it's pretty educational when people see what glass blowing entails. And it is, you know, it's a lot of skill and it's a lot of practice. It takes a long time and a lot of repetition to get really good at it. So I think people maybe come at it with more of an appreciation of it after they see it in person. My name's Katherine Gray. I'm an artist, and this is my work here on display at the Toledo Museum of Art. Glass really responds well to light. It really can capture the light and really kind of transform. You know, the glass thing can be transformed, but also even just the room that the light and the glass exist in can be really transformed. And glass, for centuries, was the main way you would see glass or encounter it would be either through stained glass windows or just windows in general. And I really kind of wanted to, in this piece, A Rainbow Like You, take that premise of, like the sun or the light of God even, like shining through glass and, with stained glass windows, it was often sort of to educate the congregation about, stories from the Bible. But I wanted to give it a more 21st century spin and think of, that inner glow that I think so many of us possess and have that kind of projecting upward through glass, but blown glass, like tableware, domestic kind of glassware forms. That kind of act as stained glass and make this big projection on the wall.
And I also got word that you were going to be a judge on a Netflix show.
I'm the resident evaluator on a series called Blown Away. So that's going to be released later this spring. And it's a competitive reality glass blowing show. And it's like Project Runway or those cooking shows. Everybody gets a challenge, and then after each challenge, somebody gets eliminated. So I didn't love the eliminating part of it, but I really enjoyed the whole experience and just seeing what all these glass artists were doing. Like, they had a very finite amount of time and a very specific kind of charge to respond to, and people did some amazing things. A big change for me in terms of what I usually make. This body of work was really inspired by, I guess if that would be the right word, of like turning 50 and thinking about the day when I really probably wouldn't be blowing glass that much anymore. And there's a few things. It really started with this piece that's behind me, where it's like four different smells that you experience in the hot shop. And you know how you think of how scent is really so closely allied with memory. And originally, I just wanted to make a scent that would remind me of being in the hot shop. And then I started to think about it more broadly in terms of like what an amazing experience it's been being a glassblower and the opportunities it's afforded me and the opportunity to travel, to work with friends, and to make my living. And I really wanted to share that experience. So I started thinking about the other ways that people could experience being a hot shop that might not necessarily be having to be a glassblower to experience that.